Hello everyone, welcome to the Geo Ecologist. I'm Dr. Krishnanand and you have been watching my videos in this series on models, theories and laws in human geography. So today we are going to learn about growth center theory by Bourdieu. Now remember, another French economist Bourdieu took this particular growth pole theory that was given by Francois Peru, which we learned in the previous lecture, and he applied this theory in Brazilian areas and also in some French areas on the basis of principal cities system concept that he devised later on. So what is this growth center approach? What is the important concept behind the center? Where it is applicable? What are its various aspects? We are going to learn in today's theory. But before we go ahead, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and do share the videos with others as well. So now, let's learn about this growth center theory and also understand how it was different from the earlier theory of growth pole. So, remember, Bourdieu, who was also a French economist, specialized in economy of territories. Now, this is where economics and geography combine together. Right? So, according to Francois Peru that we already studied his growth pole theory, it was important that growth happens around a pole, a polarized space, an economic space which is leading propulsive industry. Now remember, this came in 1955 and around the same time in 1960s, that was when Bourdieu was doing his research and he tried to apply this theory in the Brazilian area as well as also in French. So, he published two articles called Space and Growth Poles and also Economic Spaces. Now, remember, the shortcomings of growth pole theory which were criticized was tried to overcome in this theory by Bourdieu. So, Bourdieu was the economist who actually gave importance to growth pole theory. That's when it became more popular, because earlier it was just criticized and did not become popular so easily. So in 1960s, we find that the development of this concept of growth center comes in, and also which advocates the idea that this centrism approach, this center of growth approach, is not just in a propulsive firm or just in that kind of abstract economic space, but it is having a hierarchy. It starts from growth point, it develops into a growth center, and then gradually it can also become or not become a growth pole. That will depend upon several factors, right? So growth center is basically what? It's a place that provides what? Goods and services to the surrounding population. Now, whenever we say goods and services, what you take from it is central place theory. So you see the impact of central place theory as well, apart from the Peru's work that was on growth pole, right? So that is important. So it was again American concept having local geographical or regional significance, as well as not much investment was required, because remember, growth pole theory, the baseline was that investment is required. It has to become financially independent first so that it can propel growth around its linked industries, right? So propulsive firm, the benchmark is that it needs an initial input. But here it was not about that. Here it was that not much of investment is required to create a growth center, right? So these are the basic differences. Now let's elaborate and see here about the concept of hierarchy among the growth units, that is the scale. So what you observe, this growth center and growth point and its linkages like this was devised by Bourdieu, right? So from growth point to growth center to growth pole, how they are linked together with forward and backward linkages, that is important here. So what do you observe? What is growth center and what is growth point? How much would be the difference? So according to Bourdieu, it was defined that population of a growth center may vary between 1 to 5 lakhs within their zones of influence. Zones of influences till the area they provide goods and services, right? While population of a growth point, the smaller one, is less than even 1 lakh, especially in developing countries. Right? So this was his assumption in 1960s, right? So over time what happens, due to centrifugal force works around these growth points, what will happen? Due to centrifugal force, it attracts capital, brain, people, technology, all these factors of production that we say, from the surrounding region, and gradually it becomes a growth center, right? So initially it is just a growth point. And gradually, it starts to develop into a bigger growth center. And this growth center is almost like second rank cities in geographical region. It's not like a primate city or the first rank cities like in growth pole theory, right? That is what is the modification here. So in growth center, what happens? Dominant activities are secondary and tertiary activities, not the primary activities. That is important to remember. And large firms and many activities can be seen in growth center. So the cities that were growth point from 1960 to 70 have become now the growth centers of the region. You can take examples of the city development in India post World War II, right? So we observe the development of iron and steel towns like growth points, and now they have become big cities. For example, Bukhara Steel City, right? Now you can say from a growth point, it has become a growth center for Jharkhand, right? So that's one example. Then center of growth pole refers to a center or a nodal region that is having a propulsive firm. That firm, which is very independent of other factors, it has its own strength, it has its own important economic propulsion in terms of large-scale farm, innovating technology, risk-taking factors, that is what makes it an independent firm, right? And it becomes very strong in that region. So these exert one kind of strong influence on the environment around them for the faster growth. That's why they're propulsive and sustained capacity of the growth for long time period. That's important. So growth of these industries are due to several factors: localization of natural resources and man-made resources, advantages of labor and other factors, right? Maybe transport innovation as well. So in reality, these growth points are often grafted on the existing framework of these central places initially, right? That beginning of a centralization happens. But remember, there is a difference between the growth pole theory and the growth center theory only on this basis, that growth center is an evolutionary concept. It does not say that only you give in a particular region, you create a growth pole just by inducing this particular finance or this much of resource, and that becomes a growth pole, right? So this is what is the difference. So it is like an organic growth from a growth point to growth center. That's important. So although most growth points lead to the growth of industries, but remember, this is a good point here, that it was not fixed. It was not a deterministic theory in that way. So it says that not all leading industries are growth point. Maybe because of several other factors, agglomeration factors not available, maybe these industries will only remain like a growth point. They will not become a great growth center, right? So it's not necessary that every industry or every growth point for that matter would evolve into a growth center in future. So that is not based on singularity of a factor of production, right? So next concept that we see of Boudewil comes in 1960s is principal cities system, which was his work of Paris, right? So now remember, his Paris work was very important in terms of giving it an idea of the growth center and then growth pole theory approach. So what you observe, he divided his study of France into these particular aspects, like three homogeneous regions like Paris, East and West France, and eight polarized regions with centers, which are growth poles, and being called compensatory metropolis. What is this compensatory metropolis? The word is compensation, right? So the major metropolis that was Paris, and these compensatory were kind of an alternative, the newer points of development, right? And 21 planning counties for which plans were prepared. So you observe the ideas of principal cities system, those cities which were principal blocks, growth centers in France. That was to be studied here. So primary purpose of this principal cities system was to focus investments. Ultimately, investments would matter in these areas for the larger development, and objective was decreasing the regional inequality and disparity, right? So Boudewil not just studied a theory of corporatism like growth pole was, but he actually questioned and counter-questioned these regional inequalities and polarized spaces, and also tried to develop an idea where this polarization could end and overall development could happen, right? So that was the idea, to reduce regional inequality from just few centers like Paris and East and West France to the other centers, to other counties as well, right? Because fast growing Paris had a great advantage over the others, and the other areas were very slow growing. So he wanted a parity of growth, right? That's why this principal cities system was given. And further, what you observe is the difference from growth pole to growth center. These are the points to be remembered. Now remember, Peru's work was based in France only, but this was also growth center work by Boudewil of study of American concept as well. So remember, Minas Gerais region of Brazil was also studied, but here only France and its surrounding. Then you see geographic space being talked here, but here it was just economic space. Economic space is an abstract space or a defined space only on the basis of induction of large amounts of money for that matter, right, and resources in a given area. But geographical is an organic, geographically located space. Then economic space is centralized character. But here it is important that principle of accessibility, nearness, location, resource base, all these factors play dominant role in growth center approach. Then agglomeration factor was important here in growth pole. But what is important here is cumulative causation, cumulative effect of these factors, right, in growth center. Then growth pole is generally at national level. We talked in growth pole theory that the propulsive industries would have greater growth than national average. So national income would matter here. But what is important? Regional and local. So for regional economics, regional development, local development, growth center approach give another insight, right? So many times people do what? They fuse growth pole with growth center in order to understand the completeness, because one talks only about one aspect, the other tries to implement it at local and regional levels also. Further, if you observe in growth pole and growth center, it can only be applied at a country level on a larger extent, so scale or hierarchy if you see, right? And then growth center is at large geographical extent, it varies from growth point to a center to a growth pole, isn't it? Then prerequisite for a growth pole theory is at least one large country, but growth centers could be so many in within a country, right? So growth pole functions at the highest hierarchy, it is at the lower hierarchy as we know, right, growth center. And then growth pole is the center of diffusion of innovation, center for research, and center for all these investments and employment generation. But what about growth center? Growth center is intended to utilize the local resources. The geographical factor comes into the picture to develop the regional economy. So it means it is not dependent on the material coming from outside and being put into a given economic space, rather than developing the same space with its own local resources, right? That's what is growth center's difference. So growth pole signifies a centripetal force, right? Incoming things, while what you see here, centrifugal force becoming more prominent in growth center because it starts organically and starts to diffuse outside. So one is centripetal in nature, one is centrifugal in nature largely, and growth pole is merely economic concept, while growth center makes it more on the basis of the services and growth and other factors as well. So it is more of socio-economic nature, also of geographical nature, as primarily talking about a geographical space. So later on, what happened in India, the great professor R.P. Mishra, he's no more, so late Professor R.P. Mishra, who was once head of the department in University of Delhi, Department of Geography, he's also been my external advisor for my PhD. So he talked about another model called growth foci model. So remembering him very fondly, that growth foci approach which he made in Indian context was very interesting. He combined three concepts to make it. So growth pole theory, central place theory, and spatial diffusion theory, he combined to create this new concept of growth foci approach. So what is this growth foci? It is a lower order function that is important. So it was more of a function, a service that was important, an economic hub at block level, tehsil level, remember multi-level planning in India. So he was a great regional development scholar, and we say that regional planning Mishra is his another name, not just R.P. Mishra, right? So this was very fond memory with talking to him on regional planning as well. So it was not based on industrialization, rather it was more on service center. So a growth center, a growth foci basically could be based only on services that it provides. For example, at block level market, remember a small market at given district level or a block level could be growth foci for that area because it is providing services at that level, right? So what kind of services it could provide? Education, health, entertainment, social institutions, social organizations, and several factors. Right? And also it was important that it makes people aware. Consciousness was the factor here. Knowledge was the factor here. So you observe, growth foci model was not just quantitative economic concept. It was also having qualitative aspect that is very interesting in R.P. Mishra sir's work, right? So hence growth foci is based on concept of local renaissance and development of service sector. That was very interesting here. So it was to act below the growth centers and growth point. That is basically a very small center could become a growth foci, and gradually it could travel all the way including the entire national development from local development. So this was a geographical scale being taught in regional economics, regional development theory by our great professor R.P. Mishra sir. So now, when we have discussed in details about this growth center theory of Bourdieu, in the next lecture or sessions to come, we'll be talking more on different models and theories related to geography, economic geography and human geography. So stay tuned, stay safe, keep watching.